women and all Filipino people. We at CNA cannot express enough how much we appreciate the opportunity to be able to build a deep relationship based on solidarity with the members of Gabriela through multiple organizing fights around healthcare, worker, and gender justice. Claire is also a faculty member in the Department of Nursing at Cal State University, East Bay. Thank you so much, Claire, for joining us today.
Thank you so much, Alyssa. I hear you. I hear you. When healthcare is under attack, what do we do? Okay, let's do that again. When healthcare is under attack, what do we do?
Stand up, fight back.
When our communities are under attack, what do we do?
Stand up, fight back.
Hello, everyone. My name is Claire. I'm here from Gabriela, Oakland, with my kasamas, my comrades, to say we continue to be in solidarity with CNA, to say unapologetically that healthcare is a human right. That's right. In the wealthiest country in the world, it is absolutely disgusting that our government continues to use our taxpayer dollars to aid dictators, war, occupation, and militarization here in the Bay Area and around the world, while our communities are unhoused. Parents are forced to choose between rent and food and healthcare, where black and brown youth are surveilled constantly and neglected or seen as a threat by their school systems, where unions are under attack, where indigenous communities continue to be targeted and their land and water and sky desecrated. Because of colonialism and white supremacy, violence, exploitation, extraction continue to be the policy and has been for centuries. We see militarized law enforcement dispatched right here in Oakland, where people are caring for each other, feeding each other, and housing each other, and they send tanks into our neighborhoods. Is that right? Hell no. No. We have a long, long, long history of assassinations of truth tellers and human rights defenders, Zara Alvarez in the Philippines, Berta Cáceres in Honduras, and Fred Hampton right here in the United States, and so many others. That's right. And they, you know why? It's because they know that we are powerful. And we know that at least 50 union labor leaders in the Philippines just under the Duterte administration have been killed. And we know it's because we are powerful. We also know that our struggles are connected. So we are here to uplift the power of unions. That's right. I hear you, I hear you. Yes. Gabriela Oakland is a grassroots Filipino women's org fighting for the liberation of Filipinos here in the Philippines and throughout our diaspora. And this pandemic has spotlighted the living legacy of labor export. While 4% of nurses in this country are Filipino, 30% of RN deaths due to COVID have been among Filipinos. A given Filipino family can have frontline workers across industries here in the States, in different states, here in Europe, in the Middle East, and in the Philippines. And we know that no one is free until we're all free. And I say that because we see that Black, Indigenous, and Latinx communities are disproportionately dying from COVID. And we see the same inequity in this attempted vaccine rollout. And we know this is not an accident. And we know countries in the Global South are hoping to be able to get enough supply of vaccine, hopefully by 2024, and that is apartheid and that is unacceptable. Right. We in Gabriela Oakland, in the same breath, we grieve for those who've died and we join you to demand better healthcare for everyone and a healthcare system that exists so that the crisis of Black maternal death no longer exists. A healthcare system where GoFundMe is no longer needed. A healthcare system where nursing students, and I know there are nursing students here, I see y'all. A healthcare system where nursing students will feel proud and inspired to join this profession. And a system where wellness is at the heart of society. We're stronger together and we're gonna keep making this all different and we struggle together in solidarity for healthcare, for housing, education, dignity, and safety for future generations. Long live international solidarity!